return and tell the Rey. And I'm putting together a special team and I need me 8 soldiers. 8 Jewish American soldiers. Now, you all might have rumors about the Armada happening soon. Well, we'll be leaving a little earlier. They're gonna be dropped down into France dressed as civilians. And when we're down there in the enemy territory, we gotta be doing one thing, and one thing only. Killing Nazis. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I sure as hell didn't come down all the way through Sicily, jump down from the fucking airplane to teach Nazis a lesson in humanity. Nazis ain't got no humanity. They are the foot soldiers of bushwhacking, Jew-hating mass maniac, and they need to be destroyed. Now, I'm the direct descendant of a mountain man, Jim Bridger, which means I got a bit of Indian in me, and our battle plan will be that of an Apache resistance. We're gonna be cruel to the Nazis. And through our cruelty, they will know who we are. And the Germans will see the traces of our cruelty in the disemboweled, dismembered, and disfigured bodies of their brothers we're gonna leave behind us. And the Germans will be sickened by us. And the Germans will talk about us. And the Germans will feel us.
Sounds right!
That's what I'd like to hear. But I got a word of warning for all you would-be soldiers. When you join my command, you take a debit. A debit you owe me. Personally. Each and every man under my command owes me 100 Nazi scalps. And I want my scalps. And you're gonna get me those 100 scalps taken from the heads of 100 dead Nazis. Or you gonna die on trying.
I said, I'm here in the boring room. It's just another exam we have to do. I'm wasting my time, I got nothing to do. She's a job, she's a career, she's a family, she's a fucking big challenge. She's washing machines, cars, compact displays, and electrical dynamos. She's good health, long cholesterol, and dental insurance. She's fixed interest mortgage payments. She's started her home. She's your friends. She's larger than matching luggage. She's a strictly suit on her purchase in a range of fucking fabrics. She's going by. I'm wondering. Who the fuck you are on Sunday morning? She's sitting on that couch, watching mind-numbing, spirit-crushing game shows, stuffing fucking junk food into your mouth. She's rooting away at the end of your talk. Kissing you last in a miserable home, nothing more than embarrassment. For the selfish, fucked up brats, you spoke to replace yourselves. Choose your future. Choose life. Now, why would I want to do a thing like that? I chose not to choose life. I chose something else.
Come on. Liam and me, we're gonna fuck you up. Let me tell you something, pendejo. You pull any of your crazy shit with us, you're gonna piece out of the lanes. I'll take it away from you and stick it up your ass and pull the fucking trigger until it goes click. You said it, man. Nobody fucks with it, Jesus.
Obviously the big dick. And this stiff inside of you are your balls. There are two types of balls. There are big, brave balls, and there are little mincy feather balls. Of course, the dick himself has a clear vision, but he has no brain. He smells a pussy, and he wants a piece of the action. and you thought you smelled some good old pussy here. And you think you smell some good old time. But you're wrong. There is no pussy here. Just some facts that make you wish you were born a woman. Now you're shrinking. And your little balls are shrinking with you. Do you know why? That's because you got a replica written down the side of your gun. And I got Desert Eagle
0.50
written down the side of mine. Now, gentlemen, get the fuck out!
That he was managing something, no less motionless, in the wooden box, and those around him, realizing that he is no longer for anything else, burn him in no one. Or it may be even worse. A man may plan to go to Kislovodsk, a drift of undertaking, one may think. But even this is not within his power to accomplish. Because suddenly, with no known reason, he slip and fall under a streetcar. Would you say that he had managed this himself? Wouldn't it be more accurate to think that it was someone entirely else who had disposed of him?
Sitting on perches, but it doesn't hide your assholes. You don't give a shit about gods and heroes. Hercules, Oedipus, Caesar, they all have gone. And all operas written this century are boring. Boring! Look at us. Four gaping mouths I want to write this moment. Her chamberlain thinking, impotent Mozart. I must speak to Emperor at once! Her perfect thinking, ignorant himself, debasing opera with his vulgarity. Her court composer thinking, German Mozart, what he finally know about music? And Hermann Mozart himself, in the middle, thinking, I'm just a good fellow. Why do they all disapprove of me? And that's why opera is important. Because it's realer than life. A dramatic poet would have to put all those thoughts down one after another, just to represent this moment. But the poet can put them down at once and still make us hear each one. Astonishing device, voice quartet, then becoming a quintet, then a sextet, on and on, wider and wider, all the sounds multiplying and rising together, and the together creating the sound entirely new. I bet that's how God hears the world. Millions of sounds mixing in his ear just to become the unending music unimaginable to us. We composers, and that's our job. To combine the inner world of him and him and him, and to turn the audience into music. I talk nonsense all day. My tongue is stupid. My heart isn't.
Hello, I'm Dr. Arroway. We talked on the phone about my project. It's called 30. 30 is such as intelligence on other planets. I'm here to prove you that it's most funny. This is a unique time in our history, in the history of any civilization. It's the moment of the acquisition of technology. It's the moment when contact becomes possible. The very large array in New Mexico is the key to our chances for success. With its 27 linked radio radars, we can search more accurately than to any Earth conventional facility. Now we've already gotten the preliminary approval to buy ourselves some time from the government. Now all we need is the money. It's crazy. Actually, it certainly wasn't there. It's nice. You wanna hear something real naughty? I heard of a couple guys who wanna build something called an airplane. You know, you get people to go in and fly around like birds. It's a checklist, right? Or what about breaking some barrier, rockets to the moon, or missions to Mars? Science fiction, right? Look, all I'm asking is for you to just have the tiniest bit of vision. You know, to just sit back for one moment and look at the big picture. To take a chance on something that might end up in the most profound and impactful moment for humanity. For the history of history. I'm sorry. I just spent the last 18 months coming to place Texas and talking to people like you and the truth is you must change. So I'm sorry I wasted your time.
Let me tell you one story. Once upon a time, deep, deep in the jungle, there was a little engine that could chugga-chugga-chugga-chugga. This little engine mission was to take them a K-47, a nuclear payload, over the mountain to the 263 battalion. Needless to say, there was a plenty of opposition. Do you think that stopped little engine? No, he kept chugging along. Chugga-chugga-chugga-chugga. Was it even when they climbed on board of the train and pop up the eyes of conductors, and blood was dripping from his eye sockets. Think that stopped little engine? No, he kept chugging along. Chugga, 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 chugga. Choo, choo. It wasn't until they rigged the bridge with plastic explosive. And when little engine made his way across the trestle, boom! An explosion happens, and blood and guts and spin and ass was everywhere. Booba come crawling on his back, Lulu May, baby boy. He look at me and say, Ben, I can feel my legs. And I say, Booba, they ain't there. And I look down at them. There was little bloody knobs kick real fast like that. And I say, Booba, it's 30 miles to the nearest town. And if you can flip upside down and walk on your hands, you ain't gonna make it. All of a sudden, Charlie was all over the place. Just me and my sidearm. And I have no other alternative but to blast my way out. Die, Biggs! Die! You never take Major Benson Winifred Payne alive! Bang, bang! I saw what you did to my friends! Bang, bang, bang! Bang, bang, bang! Okay, now you're sleeping.